Right now, I'm working at the Ottawa Regional Cancer Center, and this is a full-service cancer center where patients get treated with chemotherapy and radiation therapy on the first two floors. Here in the third floor, we have a basic research lab and a manufacturing suite for making new therapeutics. So it's a really great place to work because I see the patients downstairs, I am able to access samples from those patients, I am able to talk to their docs and understand what their issues are, and we can really make sure that our research is relevant to the cancer patient's treatment.
Mais la découverte qui a été récemment publiée dans Nature, c'est vraiment pour la première fois on a pu montrer qu'un virus qui cible spécifiquement les tumeurs peut être livré directement dans le sang et atteindre les tumeurs qu'on dit métastatiques, donc qui ont quitté le site primaire. Et puis ce virus-là peut aller se répliquer directement dans les tumeurs et puis avoir une activité anticancéreuse.
So this discovery has proven to us that the concept that it's possible to deliver a virus as a therapeutic to cancers wherever they are in the body. And now we need to do this larger trials in patients to prove that it's effective in a large number of patients. And so we'll do a trial now called a phase two trial and then a fallout with a phase three trial in which we'll compare our virus to the current standard of care for treatment of a particular kind of cancer. And in our case, we're going to look at liver cancer first.
This is a 3D model of one of the patient's tumors that was enrolled in the clinical trial. And so what we did was we looked at virus infection. And so the patient's tumor, this part of it is kind of like a tube shape, and the green is where the virus infected. So what you can see is that the virus really infected along the entire tumor here, but the areas around the tumor, which are normal, healthy cells, did not get infected. One way that we analyzed the samples from the clinical trial was one of the surgeons would give us a tumor like this from the operating room, and it would be from a patient that had been treated with the virus. And then we would embed the tumor into a wax block, just like this. And from this wax block, we're able to make slides so that we can look at the tumor under the microscope.
You know, the one thing that was really interesting about this virus treatment was we found that the side effects were really nothing. Patients had a 24-hour flu and that was about it. So what we hope is that this virus will prove to be effective in treating cancer patients, that we'll get better outcomes, that they'll have more success with their treatment, and probably most importantly, that the side effects will be minimal. So that really patients will have a much better treatment, more effective, less toxicity, and therefore a better life. CHR has been a great supporter of my entire career, and there's no question I wouldn't be here today without the support of CHR and its predecessor. And certainly things like basic operating grants are huge for scientists like myself. So we've now got a virus which was in the clinic and is being used in people, but that came from years and years of basic research that was supported by the Canadian Institutes for Health Research.